Hey everyone, so it's been such a long time since I last filmed my last video. What I keep saying last so many times. Happy New Year everyone, and I hope you guys are all well. I hope you guys had a really great Christmas holiday, and a fantastic New Year as well. And I'm just gonna do my naughty or nice tag for the previous year, 2010. Yeah, it's gonna be like, sorry, I'm a bit sick. It's gonna be like a list of 5 naughty products and 5 nice products. And what I'll do is, I've got a few comparisons, so I'll just switch between the two and I'll tell you which is naughty or nice. So, firstly, I'll talk about lipsticks. And this is my naughty lipstick. And this is my nice lipstick, and coincidentally, they're both nudes, so it's great for a comparison, I guess. The naughty lipstick is from Barry M, which is, I think, a UK or British brand, and I bought this, I think, online, and the color just doesn't suit me. The texture is a bit drying on this one, but it's not particularly really, really bad. But the main concern here is the color. So that's Barry M 101, and it's called Marshmallow. And it's supposed to be a really gorgeous, nice nude color, but it just doesn't work for me. Just the same as another MAC nude that I had, which was Equality. That just looks like concealer on my lips and makes me look really washed out, dead, in other words, like, for lack of a better word, totally dead. And this actually really looks like concealer on a stick. Yeah, I've tried it out once and it totally looked gross. I had to take it off immediately. Just couldn't do it. So that's from Barry M. It's a naughty product. I guess I didn't try it out and I bought it online and I thought, you know, I've heard so many good reviews about this, but it just didn't work for me. And the nice lipstick is another nude and it's from MAC, from the Venomous Villains collection. And this is the one from Maleficent and it's called Innocence Beware and it's a cream sheen consistency, and that's the color there, and it's a really nice pinky nude color. It's absolutely perfect for my skin tone. I'm like an NW2025 because I'm a little bit tanner now, hopefully. I used to be NW20. I think I'm probably an NW20, closer to the NW20 because I'm quite fair. And it's a really nice pink nude color for fair-skinned girls, people. If you guys missed out on it, definitely try to get your hands on this in CCOs or whatnot, because it is a really, really nice nude color if if you've found a lot of trouble, like, you haven't had much luck looking for excellent nude, I definitely recommend this. And it is called Innocence Beware and it's definitely on my nice list for 2010. Next I'll talk about brushes, and this doesn't refer to the my naughty brush is from EcoTools, but It doesn't reflect my opinion on this brush doesn't reflect my opinion on all the EcoTools brushes, because I do have an EcoTools foundation brush which I reviewed before and I quite like that brush. I just didn't really like this one as much. And this is the EcoTools powder brush, and it's really, really, really soft. It's unimaginably soft. It's like teddy bear hair. But of course, it's not actual teddy bear hair. I can't remember what hair it uses, but it's really, really soft and really, really nice on your skin. But it just doesn't powder my face properly. As in, it does pick up the powder, but it doesn't transfer it onto the face as well. And I feel that I work really hard with this brush, and I'm just not getting, maybe I'm not getting the technique on how to use this brush, but yeah, it's really hard applying powder with this brush. I just don't know how to use it, and kudos to those who like EcoTools brushes, and I really, really think that EcoTools make really nice quality brushes. I've washed it, I think, once before, and the hair looks pretty impeccable still, and it never sheds. That's one thing I can tell you about EcoTools brushes. It has never shed before. I've used the foundation brush. It never sheds. This one, it doesn't shed. The ferrule looks very well made, and the handle is very, very sturdy, and it's just a really good quality brush. It just doesn't do what it claims to do. So yeah, I'm kind of disappointed with that EcoTools powder brush. But another set of brushes, and this I would say reflects on all the brushes in their line, I'm so, so impressed, and I picked this up only this year because I started to get really much more into makeup this year compared to previous years, and I must commend the Sephora brushes. So this one is the Sephora Professional Brush, and it's a blush brush. Sorry, that's the blush brush. And that is a, what's that called, a slanted or an angled eyeliner brush. And this is another Sephora, it's just a cream shadow brush. And all these three brushes, I think these two are from the same line, and this from a separate line, but all of them are excellently, they do such a great job at applying makeup. I've used this for foundation, which works alright, I guess. I've used it for powder brush. I've used it for powder, and for these, they're also pretty, they're really well made, firstly, and they just do such a great job. I love this brush in particular. It applies eyeshadow really well, and especially powder shadow. I haven't really used this much for cream shadow because I prefer to just use my fingers for cream shadows, but I absolutely love this brush. I definitely want to check more out from the Sephora range. Of course, here in Australia, I don't have that liberty to check those out as frequently and stuff, but I definitely want to get my hands on more of these Sephora made Sephora brushes. So yeah. And the next thing I'm going to talk about is mascara. And if you guys have watched my videos before, you'll know from another video I made, I can't remember the name of it now, but you'll know that I do not like the CoverGirl Lash Blast, and this is just the brown one, I think. And I'm not sure. Yep, it's a black brown, and I can't remember whether this is the waterproof one or the non-waterproof one. But I just don't like this mascara at all. It just doesn't do anything for me. It doesn't volumize, and the most annoying thing about this mascara has got to be that whenever I put it on, I always because my lashes aren't very thick, nor are they very long. And because they're not so long, and because this brush is really fat, I always hit the top of my lid, and I always get like brush marks, like skid brush marks on the top of my eyelashes. Like just on top or at the bottom if I'm applying it to the bottom. So the brush always touches my face where it's not needed at all. So I'm really, really disappointed with this mascara because I've heard so many people rave on and on about it, but just doesn't work for me, I guess. And that's fine because I found a really, really good one in place, and it's from Rimmel, and it's the Glam Eyes Lash Flirt Mascara from Rimmel. and it's a volume and lift mascara. I love the brush. It picks up like all my lashes and just pulls it and volumizes it. It's a very small, thin brush, in fact, and I quite like the way it's made and everything. It's just perfect. It's, you see, it's like a comb this way, but if you put it out flat, it's just like a comb. Yeah, so it's got bristles this way, and if you turn it up the other way, it doesn't. So it's a really, really good mascara to have if you don't have many lashes like I do. If you don't have very voluminous lashes like I do, and not very long lashes as well, they're really sparse and really small, like tiny and short. I highly, highly recommend that you try Rimmel Lash Flirt, because this is really good for picking up like really small lashes and accentuating them. Definitely, definitely give this a try. And where am I up to? I've got 1, 2, 3. Next, I'll talk about blush. And I have, well, this is my nice one. I don't really have a naughty blush. I would say my naughty blush was probably Orgasm. And I got it this year, which is fair enough. But I've traded it off already because the color just didn't work for me. And there's no point of, you know, keeping something that doesn't work. So yeah, I've traded that off, and I can't remember. I think I traded it off for a Chanel foundation, the 10 Innocence. And I actually really like that foundation. It doesn't give a lot of coverage, but I like it. Yeah, it's probably the shade that works well for me. Anyway, I'm going off topic here. So I have my favorite best blush of the year, of 2010, that is. And it's not really a blush, it's a mineralized skin finish, and that's how it looks like. And it's from another limited edition collection, and it's I think it's In the Groove. Yep, it's In the Groove collection. And it's called By Candlelight. And a lot of people actually use this as a highlighter. I just absolutely love this blush. I use it as a blush because during the winter I'm really pale, and this works fantastic as a blush. Sorry. So I'm not sure if you can see. Oh no, you can't see. But the color's right there. It's really hard to see, actually. And it's such an awkward position, but I'm gonna try that again. So that's the color there, By Candlelight. It looks really goldy and glowy here, but it's just a really nice glow. And if you pick up just like more of it, it actually gives you a really nice glow on your cheeks. And I absolutely love this blush. I get so many compliments when I use this blush in particular. I've had like a whole heap of compliments whenever I wear this blush, and it's just really great. Yeah, and I'm so happy that I bought this blush from the collection, because it's, yeah, it can't be found anymore, I guess, unless, of course, you have access to CCOs and stuff like that. Anyway, I'm rambling, and I don't really have a naughty blush, as I mentioned. I think that was all of my naughty products already. And I'll show you one more thing, which is a nice thing, and I've lost count completely here. Oh, I've got two more things, in fact, for 2010. One of them is, and I never really do hair products, but this is awesome, and I just had to mention this. I know a lot of you guys already use this or know about this, but I love this Batiste dry shampoo. This year I've decided I don't want to wash my hair like every day, and I want to wash it like every other day. So on those days when I didn't wash my hair, I I just use this, and it smells so good. This is the tropical flavored dry shampoo, and I love this scent. It's awesome. I haven't tried the other, like the normal one. I think the normal one smells very generic. There's like a flowery one, which I don't really like the scent of, but I absolutely love this. It smells very coconutty and holiday sort of thing, and it's awesome. I love this. Oh, and finally, another really nice product that I found in 2010 is this Too Faced French and Fabulous palette. And it comes with two bronzers. Yep, two bronzers and six eyeshadows. And there we go. That's the Pink Leopard bronzer, which I'm wearing today on my cheeks. And that's the, that's the Sun Bunny bronzer that I have right there. I haven't really used much of that bronzer yet. I think I've tried it once or twice, maybe. And got six eyeshadows. I absolutely love the first two, the Totally Toasted Beige and the Totally Toasted Brown. These are absolutely fantastic neutral colors. I wear them a lot. Like, if I want... It's very shimmery, the Totally Toasted Beige, and it's very, very buttery, as you can see. It's really, really buttery and really, really shimmery as well. Sorry, guys. My swatching skills are really bad. And that is the shade right there. It's really shimmery, really buttery. It's super creamy. I just can't tell you how much I love Too Faced eyeshadows now after this palette. And the second one, the second row is Poodle Puff Raisin and Poodle Puff Pink. And I use this sometimes as a highlighter, the pink one, because it's really nice and iridescent. I haven't tried the last two, in fact, the Ooh and Ah Black and Mess in a Dress. I get quite intimidated by bright colors like that, just because I don't go out like costume parties and stuff, or I don't really party a lot anymore. So I don't really experiment so much with my makeup. So yeah, and that's about it. The best thing I would say about this palette is definitely the Pink Leopard bronzer, which I love, in fact. I love, love, love that. And the top two Totally Toasted eyeshadows. They're super buttery and creamy. I can't say more. I can't wait to try more of Too Faced eyeshadows. But I definitely want to like use more of this before I do. So yeah. That's it for my Naughty and Nice products of 2010. I know this was a really long video. And I'll talk to you guys soon, alright? Hopefully when my hair is cut. So, see ya!